Now she's known as the Hungry Girl. Lisa Lillien is the woman behind the popular website and newsletter, and she's also the author of several best-selling books. Her latest is Clean and Hungry Obsessed. She says there is a healthy way to enjoy pizza, and she's showing us how to accomplish that this morning. Looking forward to learning more about this. Lisa, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, okay, that's a title to be proud of, the Hungry Girl.
Well,
I love that.
I am hungry. I've always been obsessed with food. I call myself a foodologist.
A foodologist, huh?
Yes, and so this is my 12th book, and I've just been helping people eat the foods they want to eat and fit into their pants.
Who doesn't want
for
that?
For about 13 years now.
Who doesn't want that? Okay, what was your idea behind starting the Hungry Girl franchise?
It was before blogs and blogging, and I just wanted to approach it and help people survive in the real world, because I'm just a regular person. I have no nutrition degree. I am just hungry.
Well, that's what's different about what you do and about what you're saying about you're not a nutritionist. You just like food, and most of us want to fit into our pants but still be able to enjoy ourselves just like you. So that's it's different what you do than what a lot of people do.
Exactly. We want to have fun doing it. That's the key. Everyone approaches it in a serious way. I am all about big portions, delicious tastes, and everything in this book is less than 375 calories.
We like you, and we like pizza. So let's talk about a way to make pizza a little bit healthier.
So this is squash crust pizza, and in the book you'll see a theme. I use a lot of produce in place of starchy carbs. So this bottom is yellow squash mixed with some cheeses. Mm-hmm. And then to make the sauce, I just use a canned crushed tomatoes with some Italian seasonings and some garlic powder.
Okay.
And you mix that up. It is so simple. This whole pizza has 277 calories, if you can believe it. You get to eat the whole thing, which again is important. We all want large portions.
We do, but when you talk about substituting veggies in for carbs, doing that often, do you notice a big taste difference?
I don't. In fact, I mean, I'm going to show you some other tricks over there. I use a lot of cauliflower. This is, by the way, part-skim mozzarella cheese, some basil, and you bake that up, and then you get to eat this whole pizza.
That's it.
The whole family will like it. It's so
simple.
That's all you have to do. Yeah, and you don't really know. A lot of people try this, and they say it tastes like bread. It's unbelievable. I mean, even my tachos over here, instead of tater tots, instead of potatoes, I use cauliflower.
Huh.
So again, you don't even taste the difference, and it really cuts the calories. That's the key.
Yeah. Well, and especially if you're not noticing a big difference, it seems like it's becoming more popular to do this, Lisa, to do like what you said, and to throw in veggies instead of the pasta.
Yeah, I mean, I say cauliflower is the new black, and zucchini is spaghetti, and spaghetti squash is spaghetti. Everything is spaghetti, because you know what? Starch and carbs and noodles, that's something we all crave, and the calorie
foods, right?
Counts are sky high. That has like 220 calories for that lasagna stuffed spaghetti squash.
Wow.
It's unreal.
It looks really good, too.
And the portion is tremendous.
Yeah, looks really good. So you have about 3,000 subscribers and followers on social media.
3
so
million.
There's obviously,
3
that's
million.
Amazing.
Yes.
And there's obviously, you know, a lot of people who are wanting to be able to live their best life, but do it in a way that's a little bit healthier.
Exactly. I have daily emails that go out every day. The daily emails go out to over 1.1 million people on Facebook. It's all about finding the foods you want to eat, staying healthy, feeling good, and not feeling like you're being deprived in any way.
That's what we want. That really is. I think this is pretty cool. You call yourself a mad scientist in the kitchen. What do you mean by that?
I mean, I just get into the kitchen and I'm like, I can make this taste like that, and all I have to do is swap out this ingredient for that ingredient, and it's all about trial and error and just having fun, and I do the hard work so the people at home don't have to.
Hey, we'll take that. We will. I want to know about this down here. What'd you bring?
That is peanut butter pie. It's one of my favorite recipes in the book. Less than 200 calories a slice. You can serve it just chilled or frozen. The crust is made of oatmeal, and that peanut butter in the middle, there's a magic ingredient. I like to use powdered peanut butter mixed with regular peanut butter to really cut the calories. And there's some Greek yogurt in there for protein. It's a phenomenal recipe, and it's 197 calories. So how can you beat that?
It looks delicious. So are all of these recipes inside of your new cookbook?
They are all in the book, and so many more. Over 150 recipes in that book. I'm really proud of it.
Very nice. Okay, so if you're interested in trying these out and learning how to eat a little bit healthier, you can get that cookbook. Obsessed is now on sale, and Lisa will be signing copies at an event today. It's at noon at the Marcus Jewish Community Center. It's on Tilly Mill Road in Dunwoody. Tickets $15 for members and $20 for everyone else. Lisa, thank you so much for coming in today and for sharing this with us. The Hungry Girl.
Thanks for having me.
We appreciate it. Time is 9:17 now, and coming up on Good Day Atlanta.